वेलकम बैक स्टूडेंट्स। टुडे आफ्टर डिस्कसिंग एप्लीकेशंस ऑफ न्यूटन्स लॉ ऑफ मोशन वी आर स्टार्टिंग न्यू टॉपिक एंड टुडे आवर न्यू टॉपिक इज रेट ऑफ चेंज ऑफ मोमेंटम एंड फोर्स। बिफोर दिस क्लास वी हैव स्टडीड इन डिटेल व्हाट द फोर्स इज and how you have defined the force is an agent which stops or tries to stop, which moves or tries to move the object. This is the concept of the force. And then we have studied about momentum. It was the product of mass and velocity. And we have discussed formula, momentum, and unit at the end. Now today we are discussing what's the relation of momentum with the force. This is a logical type of the question which is asked so many times that prove that rate of change of momentum is equal to force. So let's start with the topic. Prove the rate of change of momentum is equal to force. This is a question most of the time question is asked. Statement is that rate of change of momentum is equal to external force. Mathematically, you will write this is force. This one is linear momentum. It was written with P because it is the change of momentum. So that is del P and del T, rate of change of momentum. What's the proof? How will you prove that this rate of change of momentum is equal to force? Suppose a force F increases the velocity of a body of mass M from VI to VF in time interval del T. Then we are asked to calculate the change in momentum. Formula to calculate momentum is P is equal to mv, but it's basically change in momentum where the velocity has changed from vi to vf. This velocity is changing from vi to vf. So with the change of the velocity, what we have done, we have calculated the change in momentum, and change in momentum is mvf minus mvi. Here along with VF and VI, mass is common, and following the simple mathematical rule, we are taking common of the mass, and inside bracket we are getting VF minus VI. So the change in momentum is now in a form that is M common VF minus VI. So the rate of change in momentum is, this one is change in momentum, this one is divided by the time. So when you are dividing this change in momentum with time, that is, this was the change in momentum which we have already calculated during our last slide, and this is divided by time. Look, this is basically VF minus VI divided by time. The rate of change, it is rate of change of velocity, and this rate of change of velocity is basically called acceleration, which we have already done in our initial classes at the beginning of this chapter. So if you put the value of rate of change of velocity, you are getting it acceleration. This one is acceleration basically, and rate of change of momentum is equal to ma. So it means that rate of change of momentum is equal to force. So whenever if you are asked to prove that rate of change of momentum is equal to force, then this will be your answer. Hence it is proved. So look at rate of change of momentum. What you have done, rate of change of momentum, this is momentum, and this one is divided by time. This one is change in momentum, and again it's divided by time. So if you take the common, after taking mass common from this equation, you are getting VF minus VI divided by time. And whenever you are reaching up to this formula is equal to acceleration. It means if you put the value of acceleration in this formula, then it is equal to A. And then MA is equal to force. So it means change momentum divided by time, rate of change of momentum, that is equal to force. So from where you have started, we have started from the statement. Statement is that rate of change of momentum is equal to 4. You have written the statement of rate of change of momentum, and you were asked to prove that rate of change of momentum is equal to force. So First of all, you have calculated the change of momentum, that is MVF minus MVI. Why? Because change of velocity is from VI to VF. So after application of the force, so change of momentum will be MVF minus MVI, that is M into VF minus VI. This is basically change in momentum. We have to divide it with time. So that's why it will become rate of change of momentum. Dividing with del T on both sides, you are getting this one, del T, and here it is del T. It becomes rate of change of momentum. It becomes VF minus VI divided by T. It is equal to acceleration. And when you simplify it, it is equal to MA. It means that rate of change of momentum is equal to MA. And this MA is basically force. And hence it's proved. Hence it is proved that rate of change of momentum is equal to force. So with this, today's class ends. Hope you people have enjoyed and you have understood how to prove that the rate of change of momentum is equal to force. Thank you very much for your patience.